Now we're going to talk about Faraday's law. Now Faraday's law tells us something about magnetic flux through an area. So first of all, let me remind you what that means. This permanent magnet has a magnetic field that points to the right, it points away from the North Pole. So if we had a circle right here, just a vertical circle, then there would be magnetic flux through it, magnetic flux to the right. And you get the magnetic flux by multiplying the vector times a little bit of area and integrating over the whole area. So if the circle was right here, it would be mostly, the magnetic field would be basically to the right. So the dot product with the area would be a positive number to the right if dA was to the right. And you would say there was magnetic flux to the right through that loop. So let's think of the area as the area of this loop. Here's a loop connected to a light bulb. One side of the light bulb is connected here, curls around, two loops, the other side of the light bulb. So here's a coil of wire made up of two loops. This coil of wire has an area. So there is a magnetic flux through this coil. If I move the coil farther away, then the area of the coil is the same, and the magnetic field is getting smaller and smaller. So here, the magnetic field is smaller, and the area is the same. So the magnetic flux through this loop is smaller than it was when it was close. So that's about magnetic flux. Now, Faraday's law tells us that there's an EMF, in other words, a voltage difference induced in a closed loop. Here's a loop starts here, it loops all the way around. So it defines an area, a vertical area, which means you can calculate the flux through that area, through that loop. There's two loops here, so you get the same amount of flux through each one. The EMF, the voltage that's induced around this loop, depends on the change in the flux. So as it sits here, the magnetic flux isn't changing, but I can change it. I can bring this thing slower. I can bring the loop closer, and the magnetic flux will be larger. Now, the EMF, the voltage this induced, depends on the time rate of change of the magnetic flux. I moved that thing fairly slowly, so I wasn't changing the magnetic flux very quickly. So the time rate of change of the magnetic flux was small. But what if I move it faster? In fact, I can move either one. I can move this closer. What if I move it faster? Well, you saw what happened. The magnetic flux due to this magnet through this loop was to the right. I pushed this magnet all the way through. In other words, a gigantic change in magnetic flux. If I do it slowly, it induces a voltage in the loop that causes electrons to move. If I do it quickly, then the time rate of change is bigger. The electrons have a bigger voltage, and so there's more current. The electrons move a little faster. Go part way. You see something funny here when I move it through. The first thing you see is that the electrons move in two different directions. As I push this thing in, what's going on? Well, the magnetic field is getting larger. The electrons start to circle around this way. If you're looking from the left, the electrons circle around clockwise. If you're looking from the left, the current in this coil of wire that's connected to the bulb, the current in that coil of wire, as I push the magnet to the right, the flux through the coil of wire goes up. So I get more flux to the right. But as I finish pulling it through, out the other side, then I get, there's still flux to the right, but it gets smaller and smaller. So when I push it in, flux getting bigger and bigger, and the electrons go clockwise. When I push this thing in, the flux is getting bigger and bigger. The electrons go clockwise if I'm looking at it from the left. And when I get through and I'm pulling this away, the flux to the right is getting smaller and smaller. And so the electrons go counterclockwise if I'm looking from the left. So that's the issue of this sign here. The EMF that's induced depends on the sign. If the flux is getting larger, then you get a current that's induced. The electrons are going clockwise, so the current, I, is going counterclockwise when the flux is getting bigger. When the flux to the right is getting larger, the current is counterclockwise. Notice what that means. Your right-hand rule tells you if the current is counterclockwise, looking from the left, the current is counterclockwise, then this current that's induced produces a magnetic field to the left. Now the permanent magnet is producing a magnetic field to the right that's getting bigger. So the flux inside here to the right is getting bigger as I push this magnet toward it, and the result is a current flows that produces a magnetic field through this loop in the opposite direction. And that's what the minus sign tells you. It tells you that the current that is induced produces a magnetic field in the center of this magnetic flux through the center of this coil that is opposite to the change in the magnetic flux caused by this magnet. So if I push the magnet in, the magnetic flux gets bigger. There's a current produced that causes it to get smaller. What if I take the magnet out? Then the magnetic flux is getting smaller, and so the current flows counterclockwise, and that counterclockwise current tries to make the magnetic field in the center bigger again. That minus sign is codified a little bit in what's called Lenz's law, which is really just the direction part of Faraday's law, which just says the induced magnetic field opposes changes in the field from the outside. So the magnetic flux from the outside gets bigger, and a current flows to try to make it smaller. If the magnetic flux from the outside gets smaller, as it does when I pull this back out, and a current flows that makes the magnetic field inside bigger.